Hi, I'm Andrea Solfanelli.
And I am Alessandro Santini.
And we're talking to you from the nice garden of Sissa, the International School for Advanced Studies in Trieste. With this video, we will present you our recent work, Experimental Verification of Fluctuation Relations with a Quantum Computer, in collaboration with Professor Michele Campisi in Pisa.
The fast advancements of quantum technologies made quantum computer a reality. However, current quantum computers still do not work perfectly. Indeed, they are still very noisy. In this regard, quantum computers can largely benefit from a field of investigation called quantum thermodynamics, which studies all the thermodynamic phenomena that may occur at the quantum level. On the other hand, also quantum thermodynamics can benefit from quantum computers, since they can be employed as remotely programmable experimental platforms to address basic questions in theoretical physics. In particular, IBM Quantum provides us easily accessible real quantum processors remotely programmable through a Python-based library called Qiskit. In here, you can see a very basic example of a Qiskit code. It implements a quantum circuit for creating and measuring a Bell state.
In the quantum realm, basic thermodynamic quantities, such as the work exchanged with an external driving, are of stochastic nature. In particular, the standard way to define the statistics of work is the so-called two-point measurement scheme, whereby a system is initially prepared in a thermal state at inverse temperature beta. Then, a projective energy measurement is performed, giving an output E of n with probability P of n. After that, work is performed on the system through an unitary driving U. Finally, a second energy projective measurement is performed, and P of m given n is the conditional probability of obtaining an output E of m, given that the first measurement output was P of n. It is well known that systems undergoing such a protocol satisfy the celebrated Jarzynski identity. When implementing the two-point measurement scheme, one has to face two main problems. First of all, quantum processors typically allow for initialization of the system in a specific pure state, while a mixed thermal state is usually assumed in quantum thermodynamics experiments. Secondly, projective measurements are often so invasive that they destroy the possibility to continue the experiment after that the outcome is recorded. In our work, we propose a new method, which we call the Ancilla-assisted two-point measurement scheme. With it, we are able to overcome both these issues in a much more efficient way with respect to the previously known approaches. The trick is to introduce an Ancilla, which is a copy of the system itself. Then, we prepare the system and Ancilla in a state that is the purification of the wanted thermal state for the system alone. Then, thanks to the entanglement generated, the information of the initial state of the system is encoded in the Ancilla once and for all, and can be retrieved at the end of the protocol without influencing the system. The picture on the right shows the quantum circuit implementation of our Ancilla-assisted two-point measurement protocol.
In our first experiment, we verify the Jarzynski identity on the quantum processors. The picture on the left shows the average exponentiated work for a qubit driven by an Hadamard gate. Since the process is cyclic, this should be equal to 1, independently from beta. Moreover, the Jarzynski identity is known to be robust against projective measurements of any observables during the driving protocol. We experimentally check for the first time this theoretical result, finding a good agreement.
A typical application of quantum thermodynamics is the study of quantum heat engines. As a prototype of such devices, we consider a two-qubit two-stroke engine called swap quantum heat engine. Two qubits are initially decoupled and in thermal states at different inverse temperatures. Then, the first step of the cycle is a unitary swap gate, while in the second step, the qubits are thermalized back to their initial state, thus closing the thermodynamic cycle. Despite its broad interest, an experimental implementation of such engine were not been reported so far. Using our Ancilla-assisted method, Well, we have implemented it on the IBM architecture through this quantum circuit. And finally, we have verified the so-called quantum heat engine fluctuation relation and its robustness against intermediate projective measurements. Our presentation is finished. Feel free to contact us for questions or comments. See you at the poster section.
Thanks for watching. Ciao. Ciao. Dai, questa ci sta.